Now in this case we will see the vibration of the gear system. So what exactly the vibration of gear system? Everybody knows that gear is what, two rotating parts are in a mesh with some threads. That is called as what? Gear system. So during the fluctuation of load, there is something vibration is there. That vibration will be calculated in the terms, that is the frequency. So that you have to see in this case. Let's see the vibration of gear system, what exactly it is. Now this is a turbo generator gear system which contains the gear system. Consider a turbo generator, that is turbine, gears and generators. So these are the types, that is the turbo generator gear system. The analysis of this system is complex due to the presence of gears. Let I be the speed ratio, that is I is equal to speed of turbine to the speed of gears. Now see, the before going to any calculations, we have to got the term, that is this figure. What figure shows that? Figure shows the turbine, then again gears and generators. Now what is function of turbine? Turbine which convert the hydraulic energy, pressure energy, steam energy into the mechanical energy. That's called turbine. Okay, J1 be the polar moment of inertia of that particular turbine. Shaft 1 having the torsional stiffness KT1. Then again we are connecting to the gears. What is function of gear? Gear of function of gear is what? To connect the two parts with the variation in the speed and the torque. That can be done through the variation in the diameter, variation in the number of teeth on the wheel. Okay, JJ1 is the polar moment of inertia of gears 1. JG2 is nothing but the what? Polar moment of inertia of the gear 2. KT2 is nothing but the what? The torsional stiffness of gear shaft 2. Okay, again generator. What is function of generator? Generator which convert mechanical energy into the electrical energy. Now come to the our operating part. I be the what? Speed ratio. How to find out the speed ratio? That is speed of turbine to the speed of generator. Means what is at the input and what is at the output. That we have to calculate it. That is known as what? Speed ratio. Now what is our first steps to analyze? System is to convert into original gear system into the equivalent rotor system. Okay? With respect to their shafts. Now the conditions were, when the inertia of gear is inelastic, under that conditions, a basis of conversion of consider the engines energies, that is kinetic energy and potential energy, that is we are already discussed. For a equivalent system should be same that of your original system. Thus if the theta and theta 2 are the angular displacement of the rotors of moment of inertia J1 and J2 respectively, then neglected the inertia of the gear, that is kinetic energy and potential energy of the original system, are given by T is equal to 1/2 J1 into theta dot 1 square plus 1/2 J2 into theta dot 2 square. So U is equal to 1/2 KT1 into theta 1 square plus K2 1/2 KT2 into theta 2 bracket square. Since the theta 2 is equal to I theta 1, then the above equations can be written as T is equal to 1/2 J1 theta 1 dot square plus 1/2 J2 I theta dot 2 square is equal to 1/2 J1 theta dot 1 square plus 1/2 I square into J2 theta dot 2 square. So we got something in simplification, that U is equal to 1/2 KT1, that is the torsional stiffness, theta 1, that is the angle of shaft 1, theta 1 square plus 1/2 KT2, same similar to second, theta 2 I theta 2 bracket square is equal to 1/2 KT1 theta 1 square by simplification plus 1/2 m bracket I square KT2 into theta 1 square. Now we have to got the some equivalent turbo generator gear system, turbine and generator. KT1 Ni 2 square theta KT2, okay. Now after that, which obtained by multiplying the inertia and stiffness to the second shaft by I square by keeping the system as the first part. So we got that equivalent stiffness of two rotor system, that KTE is equal to I square KTE1 into KT2 divided by KT1 plus I square into KT2. Okay. So thus the frequency of system is given by omega n is equal to m bracket KTE m bracket J1 plus I square J2 into divided by I square J1 into J2. This terms in the case of the radian per second. Now the main inertia of the gear is considered. Now this is all about the considerations, and before this we have seen that not considerations. So if the inertia of the gear is not neglected, then the equivalent system with respect to the first part, in the same manner we are finally why with the consideration of the three rotor system. By the considering, we have to consider the three rotor. If there is no inertia, we have to consider the two rotor system. Okay. So this is the case, that is the turbine J1 and JG1 plus I square and JG2 into generator. So this is the case where we will see the interactions. Then again coordination system and coupling we will see in the next lecture. But once again revise this, the what is the gear system and what is the case. So in this case we will see the turbine generator gears, that is the how it will be varies. Okay, look at this once again. This is turbine, this is the gears, this is the generators. Okay, KT1 KT2, this is the particular the terms name, that is a torsional stiffness of shaft 1 and torsional stiffness of shaft 2. J1 and J1 is what? J1 and J2 is what? J1 is nothing but what? Polar moment of inertia of turbine. J2 is equal to polar moment of inertia of generator. JG1 and JG2, what? JG1 is nothing but the polar moment of inertia of the first gear. JG2 is the polar moment of inertia of 2. So again we are considering the speed ratio, that is speed of turbine to the generator. Then again we are terms written in the kinetic energy and potential energy of the original system. Then again we are converting into the equivalent system. Then we are considering, that is the non-consideration of the inertia forces, means what? Inertia force is neglected. And in the second case, that is we are considering the inertia forces. So we will got the three rotor system. So keep in mind this particular thing, when there is no consideration of the inertia of gear system, that is a gear inertia is neglected, under that condition you have to consider two rotor system. If there is considerations, we are considering the inertia forces, that we call as what? Three rotor system. So this is all about the case of your gear system, that is the vibration of the gear system, we can say that.